spirit of unity. I stand before you in the name of the Holy Spirit. Oh God, I thank you, God.
Church folks really hurt you. You feel like you're under a
under the floor, under the pigeon, in the prison. Now that's some real church here. Amen. Anybody been hurt by church before? You felt like you was on the ground. But God. But God. But God still had a plan for Jeremiah's life. You can try to put me any way you want to put me, but God still got a plan for my life. The people of Israel were so filled with sin and filth that they didn't want to hear anything about God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. That's a sad situation. Sad to say that it's almost like that now.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. God knew that Jeremiah would possess everything that he needed in order to do the special assignment in which was birthed through him. Amen. Jeremiah's identity was birthed forth before he was even born. Before he was even conceived, his identity was already there. Before you were born, you had an identity. The identity itself probably has come in and taken it and blurred your vision, but you still have an identity. Amen. I don't care what people say, you have a God-given identity. Amen. God knows us intimately. He valued us before existence. And he actually valued you more than you value you.
Amen.
He valued you some stuff that we do, we wouldn't do it. You know when we do stuff, then we say, oh, I shouldn't have done that. When you eat the wrong food, Lord, I shouldn't have ate it. So much that he gave us a purpose before we had a present. Now that's deep. A purpose before you had a present. Now that's the God we serve. That's the God we serve. Before God formed you in the womb, before you were even conceived, before your father and mother thought about you, God knew you. He knew each of you. He knew you. Before you were born, God had a plan for your life. A wonderful, beautiful plan for your life. He knew your destiny. He knew the plan he had for your life. Jeremiah 29:11 said, for I know the thoughts or the plan that I think toward you, said the Lord. Is that what Shaka said? This is what the Lord said. So whatever situation you're going through right now, know there's a peaceful end coming to that. I don't care how much hell you get through right now, peace is on the way. And it has to end. Every storm run out of rain. Thank you. disobedient.
That's right.
We are all made sinners.
Amen.
We are all born with a built-in death warrant,
all right,
which is our sin nature.
Amen.
For the wages of sin,
amen,
death warrant.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
We are all slaves to sin except for one, Jesus,
right,
who did not inherit the sin nature because he was conceived without the aid of man.
That's right.
That's why Mary was made pregnant by the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
Okay?
That's right.
This is why there was no need to bypass the sin nature of man when he took on human flesh.
Yeah.
Although we were born with a built-in death warrant, I have good news. There's always some good news. Always some good news. At the point of salvation. But God. Confessing with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believing in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. That's good news. Ownership rights.
Right.
No longer under the sin nature.
Yeah.